starting from the plane. You ready yourself? It's another game, it's another round, and you're about to drop in. Where we drop in, boys, is the meme, and Battle Royale is the game. Long before Lars uttered the word Royale on the stage, there was always rumors of the Battlefield Royale idea. And Battlefield 5 actually has a chance to pull this off. Now, this footage is brought to you by EA Game Changers, as EA was nice enough to let me record this at EA Play. But today, we're going to go over why I think Battlefield 5 has a chance at Royale. There was a lot of talk of Battlefield and how Battlefield could do Battle Royale, what it would be, and what to expect out of it. Well, for all I know, Battlefield 5 could be one of the best out there. Battlefield features some of the best netcode after the Battlefield 4 debacle, of course, but it also features excellent gunplay, and with the recent changes to the gunplay mechanics in Battlefield 5, I foresee that Battlefield 5 actually has a decent chance to run up here and actually maybe walk away with the title of an awesome BR. So let's start off with gunplay mechanic changes. The removal of suppression in Battlefield 5 immediately makes gunplay feel that much better. There's a lot of people who are not a fan of suppression, but there is also some people who are. So for those of you who like suppression or really enjoy the immersion of the idea, this is probably not specifically for you, but at the same time, being able to land your shots on where you aim is probably going to be a good highlight for any BR or competitive title if it manages to reach that place in the future. Now, I foresee that a good BR and a good adoption of the competitive mindset for Battlefield 5 could take this title a really, really good distance upon really capitalizing on what a lot of people have been asking for in the community. Now also, removal of suppression isn't the only thing that has affected gameplay, or gunplay at that. The reduction of the ammo account that you spawn with is a very good start on the gameplay changes, as well for things like BR, where there's going to be scarcity of items, and the way that you react to the scarcity of items and how well you utilize ammo is going to be a large part of a BR title. And I think Battlefield 5 has already taken that into account. Another thing that's changed that I don't know if a lot of people have been talking about is now you can no longer scavenge kits off of people. It's a big thing I was known for in Battlefield 3, 4, and 1, which is scalping kits off of support players to get myself ammo, scalping kits off of medics to get myself health, scouts for flares, and assaults to help try to take down tanks. Well, that's not possible anymore. Now when you try to take something off of a player's kit, all you take is their primary weapon. This is another thing that is also seemingly geared towards the whole Battle Royale effect, because you'll no longer be able to scalp ammo off of a dead enemy. Now you'll be forced to actually have to find ammo or take the gun that they have with the ammo with it as well. Another thing that is, seems like it's already been tuned for a Battle Royale style game is that when you're working in squads, in the groups, in your squad whole setup, when your team wipes, everybody is no longer revivable. Much like a squad wipe in a BR, you would normally, in a Battlefield title, be able to revive an entire team after they're down. But now, a squad wipe is a complete removal from the battlefield, similar to a squad wipe in a BR, where no longer teammates can help you or pick you up. It sends you back to the global. So it feels like to me that gunplay and squad mechanics for Battlefield 5 have already been tuned for a BR. We're no longer going to see a separation in game mechanics versus the standard multiplayer and the BR style multiplayer based on the way that the mechanics have changed for Battlefield 5. Now, I know a lot of people were really, really concerned on how it could separate the core gameplay from a Battle Royale to a Battlefield multiplayer title standard, and I think that the devs have already thought this through, that one of the biggest complaints for competitive Battlefield is the fact that the rules, the way that you play the game, and the way that it's viewed is already so different from the standard Battlefield entertainment style that people won't be able to easily adopt it. But people who pick up Battlefield 5 from the beginning in multiplayer appear to already be playing the style that would be used for a BR or for a BR title that might exist inside of a Battlefield title. So I know a lot of people were already afraid that, you know, they were gonna have to change mechanics, that they were gonna have to change the way that you play the game just to change it for a BR, but I think that the game has already been catered to that. Another thing to look at in the gunplay is now the recoil-based accuracy system, opposed to the, I guess you would have referred to it as random bullet deviation system that we had previously in Battlefield 1. This makes for a lot more responsive gunplay. Not only that, but a lot more of a, I guess, reliable gunplay. And you'll find it, that whenever you're exchanging gunfire, that you will be able to expect on where you should win and where you should lose based on how you performed, rather than the suppression base, the bullet deviation base, the spread versus fire rate. The recoil system is going to work much better for a BR style title that people are familiar with. Now, the second thing on the list to note is Battlefield already does large gameplay, large style gameplay. Vehicles, players in large counts, up to 64, and large maps. It's something that Battlefield has done for a long time now, and it's done something they do exceptionally well. And the netcode for gunplay on this size of map that they generally deal with is a really hard thing to nail down, but DICE has already done it. This isn't their first rodeo on large gameplay style netcode. This is something that they can easily accomplish. You know, when you see other titles start off with a BR, that's something new to them. That's something that they haven't really had to mess with before. But Battlefield is one of the kings of original netcode for large style engagements. So something like the netcode for a BR that is nice and crisp like a Battlefield title is going to go exceptionally far for making enjoyable gunplay that you feel like you are actually responsive with, you know? It's not something that you're just going to wonder, hey, can they actually make these long distance shots matter? Can they make them work? Do they have the bullet drop already kind of in mind on how this is supposed to work? Of course they do. It's a physics-based system. Frostbite is beautiful, and they can make a beautiful, hard-working BR from the start. It's what they've already started on in lots of Battlefield titles before, and it's something that they're going to continue to improve on Battlefield titles now. And that style of gameplay in a BR, it could really take off. There's really a chance for it to do well on that. Little changes to the way that the squad work together in the game are also very well done already for a Battlefield title, and also done really well for a BR title. The new squad revive mechanic is very much down the same line of a BR title. 8 roughly second revive for a squad mate, that screams a BR style revive. The introduction of ammo stations is also done very well for any BR style title, where you now have to go and interact with something to re-ammo yourself. And who knows, even the fortification system could even work with BR. Finally, you're no longer stuck in an open field with no cover. You can actually build yourself a defense position. It would actually give you a chance to fight in an unfavorable territory that is now going to be favorable for you in the gunfight. There's a lot of things that are working for DICE in the idea of a Battlefield 5 Battle Royale. And I would really love to see them succeed, because there's a lot of a market now where Battle Royale is what people want to see. And I think that with DICE being able to produce something in the form of a Battle Royale, I think they could do it exceptionally well. And it would be such a shame for people to really count out Battle Royales just because other titles already have them, and they don't believe that the new titles can feature them as well. I think that there's a good chance that Battlefield could actually outperform quite a few other Battle Royales and really give something people some that they didn't know that they wanted. And I'm looking forward to that. We've already seen DICE been able to pull off scavenger mode before, which is a really early version of a Battle Royale. You spawn in with next to nothing, you go and pick up weapons, you fight until the death. It sounds like a Battle Royale to me, and I think that the future of Battlefield 5 Battle Royale, it looks bright. I really want to hear what you guys think about it, though. I know that there's going to be a bunch of positive, a bunch of negative, and I want to know everything about it because I want to see where you all stand. And I want to see how open you are to the idea of possibly featuring a Battlefield 5 Royale. Let me know what you think could be added to make it better. Let me know what you think needs to be taken away or changed to be made it better. And as always, if you have enjoyed this video, please leave a comment, a like. You can share on your social medias. It really helps me get bigger, get out to more of you, and be able to have good, interesting conversations with y'all about how the game could progress to be better. Again, I really appreciate y'all's time. Thank you so much for watching my video. And until next time, peace.